Hello everyone. So here we are with the Google experience running on the Galaxy S4. Now, if you don't know, Google have done a deal with Samsung and HTC to resell their flagship devices, but instead of having them coming equipped with HTC and Samsung's own modifications to Android, Google are selling them purely with Android. So just Google, none of the extra stuff. So there's no TouchWiz here, there's no Samsung applications here, there's no extras, as it were. You get just Google, and that's your lot. Now, it does come with some caveats. You are losing access to Samsung software, so it means that certain features simply aren't there. You also have a much more limited camera in my view as well. The Google camera, not quite as good as the Samsung camera. There's not as many software optimizations running after you take a picture, which does make a bit of a difference. You get the pure Google experience, which means Google Apps and Google Apps only. But everything is very fast and fluid. This isn't like running something like CM10 that's not been well optimized for the hardware, particularly at this point, or where, you know, the source code wasn't available for the particular chips that are being used or anything like that, making developers' lives harder in the developer community. What we have here is Google and Samsung working together to effectively release a great software stack for pure Android experience, coupled with Samsung very, very good hardware. What we get is an experience which is as fluid and beautiful as you could possibly imagine. And really, this is the way that Android was always intended to be. For my mind, this is what I've always been waiting for on a Samsung device, not having to actually hack it and use a third-party ROM, but using something that is officially sanctioned, as it were, by Google and Samsung, but that brings the experience back down more to what I remember when Android first launched. Pure, fast, capable and flexible. I don't have to wade through a load of stuff from Samsung. I can just install the software I need, the updates, a little tweaks and packages I want, and off I go. None of the bloat. Now, one thing that's worth mentioning, if we come into the settings, we're not actually gaining any additional storage space. The actual software that kind of sits underneath the software layer of, you know, the Android desktop, as it were, that we use, that does still take up a huge amount of space. So those binaries, I'm afraid, still present. They have to be, otherwise the device simply won't work. And so, you know, we're not really gaining any additional space back. Total space there, 9.25 gig with the, you know, Google experience installed. Now, to actually do this, this is a standard Samsung Galaxy S4 that was rooted and had a custom recovery run on there, running on it. Now, what I did is, over on the XDA developers forums, the source code was released yesterday, and basically the developers there have then recompiled it into something that we can flash on our phones. And to do that, you would go into your custom recovery, touch recovery or what have you, and simply flash the file. You need to make sure you clear your Dalvik. Do basically a full wipe before you install this, otherwise it will have all sorts of problems when the device reboots. Basically, you need to obliterate all of the Samsung stuff off there. So full wipe, full cache wipe, Dalvik clear. I would also recommend doing a permissions fix as well after you've installed the ROM. It does seem to have a few issues otherwise. For me, it took around about 20 minutes to get everything up and running with a little bit of trial and error, but once it was up and running, as you can see, it's absolutely fine. I've tested the camera, I've tested the Wi-Fi, I've tested the Bluetooth, all are working spot on. It's very difficult for me to actually see anything in here that isn't working absolutely perfectly. So, will you be getting a Google Experience Galaxy S4 or HTC One? Is there anything you'd like me to check out on this device? What would you like me to test? Let me know in the comments, and I'll be doing a follow-up video tomorrow, where we go through the Google experience in more detail and take a look and see what's changed, or more importantly, what new things and new flexibility we have now the TouchWiz is gone.